One of the most challenging tests of the year for Honda's IndyCar stars, Sunday in the sun at Iowa Speedway, the Iowa 300. Honda's teams had battled all weekend to find some speed, and once the green flew late on this Sunday afternoon, it became a day of adjustment and strategy. Mikhail Aleshin, wheeling the 7 car for Schmidt-Peterson Motorsports, fastest among the Hondas, he qualified 9th and raced his way to 7th in the first 40 laps. Graham Rahal, maybe Honda's top championship threat, moved to 11th early on. Four pit stops in this 300 lap are the first stops under green. Just like at Indy, rookie Alexander Rossi on a way different fuel and tire strategy, running a much longer first segment. He would lead laps before stopping for the first time on lap 62. But once the first round of stops was complete, Rossi had settled back into 14th. One of Honda's best hopes here, Ryan Hunter-Reay, saw his chances end just past 100 laps in, a mechanical issue ending his bid to win his fourth Iowa race in the last 5 years. That brought out the first caution at lap 111 and resulted in a lengthy cleanup. The green would reappear with 130 laps complete. Aleshin continued his strong day, restarting 9th. Then another caution as the defending series champion's engine expired, setting up a second restart with just more than 100 to go. And look who's on the charge. The mayor of Hinchtown, the Indy 500 pole winner. Frustrated at Road America, James Hinchcliffe didn't qualify well either here. He started shotgun, 22nd on the day. But the Schmidt-Peterson Honda pilot was on a mission, climbing to 8th with less than 100 to go, while his teammate Aleshin had moved to 6th. And Indy winner Rossi, with 80 laps left, had steadily climbed back into the top 10 as well. But caution with 53 to go for a spin on the backside of the course. Aleshin up to 4th as pit road opened with 50 laps left. The stop shuffled the running order, the green reappearing with 40 left. Aleshin is 5th, Rossi 6th, Hinch is 8th. Final circuits, the 7 and 98 would hold station, Rossi grabbing his second best finish of the season, while Aleshin matched his career best atop 5.
Definitely feels very nice to be top 5 here and very unique track like Iowa, you know. So definitely shows team potential.
I think we've always been solid on ovals. Yesterday was an anomaly for Andretti around here. I mean, we all know the record they have. It's a shame that got broken today, but I think we did a good job to pull ourselves out of a hole.
Hinch hung on over the final 40 laps, persevering to bag a 9th. Still considering his row 11 start, a strong day for the mayor. For Hinch and the rest of Honda's IndyCar stars, a big week ahead. It's the Honda Indy Toronto next Sunday.
Toronto is the reason I got into motorsports, was going to that race as a kid, and had to sit on the sidelines last year, which was tough to swallow, but it'll be really nice to be back home, and hopefully we can put on a good show for everybody.
We'll have the coverage for you from Exhibition Place. At Iowa Speedway, I'm Rick Benjamin, Honda Racing HPD Trackside.